Okay, this video is What is Science? And what I'm trying to do is help you to think in a more effective way so you can stay healthy and stay out of problems. So first of all, if you know, the question is, why is it that you, as a student of the vegan diet, can cure more chronic disease patients than can the Ivy League? Okay, there's obviously, you know, a disconnect there. How come the Ivy League essentially can never cure a chronic disease? They define them as chronic, meaning they can't be cured. I'm talking about coronary artery disease, hypertension, diabetes. And the reason is they don't know diet and toxicology. And diet and toxicology is at least 70% of disease. So if they don't know 70% of disease, what that means is you as an individual need to learn these things if you want to protect yourself from those diseases, because they can't do it. Okay, and so that's going to get into how come, if doctors and medical students and pre-meds are studying science and medicine so much, how come they don't know anything about chronic disease? They know very little about chronic disease. All right, so we're getting at an important point here. You know, what is science? A couple quotes from Voltaire are helpful. Voltaire says, "It is dangerous to be right when the established are wrong." Yeah, if you contradict the so-called authorities, experts, you could get in trouble, okay? But you know, in science, you should be allowed to have a contradictory opinion. Voltaire said, "I'm very fond of the truth, but not at all of martyrdom." And then Voltaire says, "I want my tailor and doctor to believe in God so they don't rob me." Okay, so that's Voltaire from 1700s in France. Okay, so well, why do I mention that? Because this is an important point. I want my tailor and my doctor to believe in God so they don't rob me. I can assure you, if they don't believe in God, there is a much, much, much higher risk they are going to rob you, okay? And science needs God a lot more than God needs science. So, again, old definitions of science would be things like you can do an experiment and then the results are reproducible. If you look at the modern journals in a widespread variety of fields, in the medical fields, in the chemistry, synthetic fields, the results in those journals, they're not reproducible. They're not true. That's a big deal. Corporations have bought so many of the medical journals that they're just a joke. When you, for example, if you go to the grocery store and you see a bunch of magazines about mutual funds, you know, if you have a brain in your head, that that's not really economic science. Those are advertisements. And it's the same thing with a medical journal. If you open it up, all those articles about drugs, that is not science. Those are advertisements. Typically, that research is paid for by those companies. So you have to take that all with a grain of salt. Okay. A plausible, falsifiable theory that makes accurate predictions. Yeah, if it can make a lot of accurate predictions, then there's something useful about it. You know, if it's the best available explanation for something, you know, it might be tentative, but it still enables you to work in that domain. That's useful. The other thing to remember is modern scientific method, it arose in Europe based on the Catholic Church. That's a fact. Anybody who studied it knows that that is well documented. And what I'm saying is science is being taken over by an atheistic university system and it's destroying it. Atheism destroys a lot of things. If you haven't noticed already, there's many institutions, they get taken over by the atheist mentality and they just go down the tubes in terms of their quality, in terms of their respect for meritocracy. Because what happens is the atheistic institution just says, we're going to do things, whoever is ruling it usually just says, we're going to do whatever we want. And then usually whatever they want is whatever makes the most money for them or gives them the most power. So truth is out the window. Truth is a delicate thing. It has to be respected and protected. Otherwise, it doesn't last very well in an atheistic environment. And so here's like where science is going. Like when I hear somebody say science, the average stupid person thinks, oh, that's like the equivalent of God in the modern world. There is truth. No, most of the time when somebody says science, what they mean is lies. They mean advertisement. It's BS. Okay, so pseudoscience is the, you know, the fake so-called god of atheism. It's nonsense most of the time. Another example, as I told you, you know, in all these Ivy League schools, all their textbooks, they're all full of lies. Their atherosclerosis chapter, it's BS, okay? There's nothing about vegan diet in there. There's no mention of Kempner, of Ornish, of Esselstyn, okay? In their heart disease chapters, in their diabetes chapters. There's no mention of Shulman. There's no mention of Brownlee. There's no mention of Roy Taylor and their hypertension chapter. There's no mention. All the people who made the significant discoveries, they're not in any of the textbooks, including the recent Harvard editions. I'm telling you, it's a joke. No mention of leaky gut in the autoimmune disease chapter. No mention or minimal mention of metabolic theory, next to none, in Warburg. Okay, Warburg. For TBI at the Ivy League institutions, they recommend Mediterranean diet. That's a terrible diet that causes brain damage. That's what they recommend at the so-called best hospitals. Whenever I hear the word best hospitals in the United States, I start laughing. Yeah, what are the best hospitals? You know, they're going to say things like Cleveland Clinic, Mayo, Harvard. Okay, then go to those companies' websites and you will see endless crap and stuff that is not true. At those hospital websites, the so-called best hospitals in America, nonstop ignorance and lies, okay? And why is that? Well, if you screw up the Mediterranean diet, then you need drugs and surgery. That's profitable. That's money. So what I'm teaching you is you got to think for yourself, because if you don't think for yourself, you're going to get chumped by far, most likely. When you open up a biochemistry book, you know, I used to think, you know, the Lupertz-Dreyer biochemistry textbook was the book. Now I look back at it, it's a whole bunch of BS. When you read the metabolism, you will see all kinds of things in there. They're just flat out not true. And then things that are useful to know about, things like F-, things like GP, things about most of the mitochondrial inhibitors, circuit inhibitors, none of that is in the book. None of it. And I can tell you, most modern biochemistry books, and I've looked at a whole bunch of them, they're going to end up recommending something like Mediterranean diet, keto, or low carb. That's completely ignorant. Completely. Okay? And I told you, the Harvard guy, Willett, you know, BS artist with his food pyramid, putting right at the bottom all these omega-6 oils, completely stupid, okay, dishonest. I'm sure, you know, somebody is rewarding them for that type of behavior, because it's completely against what is known. Okay, psychology books lie. You know, there's way too much push in psychology and psychiatric fields for drugs. You know, and even Mr. Famous Jordan Peterson, okay, he lies. He keeps saying, oh, you know, you need these meds. You need these meds. These meds are good for this and that. Yeah, right. And he tells people to eat a meat-based diet. Don't get me wrong. He does say some good things. He is a bright guy. He does do some good things. Okay, but he also, you know, plays that game. I don't know what percentage you want to call it. Well, he'll tell you some good stuff, and then he lies to you, you know, to push you in the other direction. Eat meat. You know, take psychiatric drugs. That's all BS. That he doesn't believe in God, and then he gets interviewed by Christian churches and other places, you know, they're just stupid, okay? Science is whatever Big Pharma says it is. They've got, you know, the golden rule means whoever got the gold makes the rules. That's checkbook science. Basically, they just pay for it. They buy the journal. They buy the scientists. The scientist has to tell them whatever they want to hear or they never can get another job. Okay, so we're sort of in this age where science is becoming a joke. Science is whatever big money damn well says it is. And they bully people into having to accept them. If you don't accept it, you're going to get in trouble. And it's all fake, okay? And then they try to intimidate people. That's all BS, you know? People will, so that's what I'm trying to say is people will, when you read history, what you should be saying to yourself is, would this happen nowadays? And what I'm saying here is, of course it's happening nowadays. People say that some, you know, authority figure was unreasonable back in 1500. Well, guess what? They're more unreasonable nowadays. And then nowadays, the latest push is they're going to try to charge people for spreading misinformation. Gee, if somebody tells you the truth that low-fat, low-sodium vegan diet can reverse coronary artery disease, is that going to get labeled by Big Pharma? They're going to pay somebody to tell you that that's misinformation? So it's important that people have spots where they can get good information. And I think the best thing is go to a variety of sites. You get it from more than one place, and then you can figure it out for yourself. And this idea that the so-called experts, most of these so-called experts, they're just a bunch of phonies who are paid off to get grant money. If you work at an Ivy League school, you have to make, and you're in internal medicine or something, or related fields, internal medicine subspecialties, you're going to have to do whatever Big Pharma says, or you won't get any grant money, and then you'll lose your job there. And so what I'm saying is, you know, it's been described that this is making so-called science like a Trojan horse to trick people. Basically, people think, oh, science, that means something's true. No, it doesn't. Usually it's BS. Okay, so anyways, I just given you the heads up. Most of the time, when you hear somebody say this is based on science, you should know that there's a very good chance they're just making that upper line to you. And then you, if you say, well, it's based on science, give me some example. What's the research study? What were the results of the study? Does that correspond to other things, to epidemiology, to other historical events, to other things you can rationalize it? So this is important to know, because science is atheistic science is largely a dishonest joke.